हाय हेलो, हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स? वेलकम टू एमडीएस कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट कोरटला एंड आई एम योर कोच मोहम्मद सोहेल। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक अबाउट द ब्रिटिशर्स, द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, गवर्नर जनरल्स, गवर्नर ऑफ बंगाल, वाइस रॉयस ऑफ इंडिया, गवर्नर जनरल्स ऑफ इंडिया। So serial wise we are going to discuss about it in the continue 4-5 videos. So in this video we are discussing about the governor of Bengal and the governor generals of Bengal. Okay friends, in another video we will discuss about the topic governor generals of India. In another video we will discuss about the viceroys of India. So serial wise we are going to capture about the datas. So most important questions in every exams, if you take the SSCs, UPSCs, group 1s, group 2, group 3, group 4, every exams in state and central level, you will about to find the questions on Britishers, rules of Britishers, reforms of the generals, Lord Dalhousies, Lord Wavell, Lord Canning, Lord Warren Hastings. So most of the important Governor Generals and important Viceroys questions are be framed in examinations. So it very useful to the each and every candidate, because in now not in Telangana, it also useful for Telangana and all for India, because Britishers has ruled all over India. So in the Telangana also, maybe the Chief Minister will is going to soon going to announce the notifications of the exam. So it is useful for the every candidate. So utilize it friends. So let's see the today's topic, Governor of Bengal and Governor Generals of Bengal. So friends, today we are discussing about the Governor Generals of Bengal from 1757 to 1833. And before Governor Generals of Bengal, the most prominent Governor of Bengal, that is Robert Clive. He was the Governor of Bengal, not the Governor General of Bengal. So before Robert Clive, so many Governor of Bengals were present in Fort William, Calcutta, but Robert Clive is the he is not the founder of British Empire, but he was the turning point to the growth and develop of the British in India. So here I will explain how the Robert Clive became the founder of British Indian Empire. So see, the governor of Bengal, he is the most prominent governor. So from Robert Clive only Britishers and East India Company has been growth and developed their everything. So he is the founder of British Indian Empire. So Robert Clive is also known as the founder of British Indian Empire. So he served as a civil servant, military head and first governor of Bengal. So Robert Clive was a civil servant and also the head of the military, the forces, and first governor of Bengal, not governor general. He is the first governor of Bengal for the East India Company, the East India Company which were ruling from England, London. So see, Robert Clive, he became the governor of Bengal from 1757 to 1760 for 3 years, and after in 1760 he resigned to the post and returned to England, and he returned came back to India in 1765 and rejoined as governor of Bengal in 1765 to 1767 for 2 years. So totally 5 years Robert Clive has been worked as a governor of Bengal. So friends, here we see the administration of Robert Clive. So in his reign, Battle of Plassey had occurred. Battle of Plassey, the famous battle in the Indian history and the turning point to the East India Company and the Britishers to grow in India. Battle of Plassey 1757 marked the beginning of British rule in India under Clive administration. So Robert Clive was a very intelligent and elegant leadership he has in it. So he fought the Battle of Plassey and it marked as the British rule starting, means the developing of the acquiring of the British in India. So see here,
एंड ई आई सी मीन्स ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इन शॉर्ट फॉर्म EIC, ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी गॉट राइट टू कलेक्ट रेवेन्यू एट बंगाल बिहार एंड ओरिस्सा अंडर द ट्रीटी ऑफ अलाहाबाद 1765. इन 1765 द ट्रीटी ऑफ अलाहाबाद, व्हाट इज द ट्रीटी ऑफ अलाहाबाद, दैट द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी कैन हैव द राइट टू कलेक्ट द रेवेन्यू टैक्सेस फ्रॉम द बंगाल स्टेट, बिहार स्टेट एंड द ओरिस्सा स्टेट. ओके फ्रेंड्स, रिमेंबर ऑल दिस इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स विच विल बी फ्रेम्ड इन योर एग्जाम्स. So next is dual administration in Bengal. So in Robert Clive's reign, in his rule, dual administration means double governance. Double government was formed in Bengal and was ruled by the Britishers. This is the most fiercing administration. Dual administration in Bengal, 1765 to 1767. Nearly 7 years the double governance in Bengal has been occurred. And marked the beginning of the economic loot in India, and the Britishers have started to loot to economic in India. So the economic in India was decreasing day by day. So the company got Diwani jurisdiction while the Nawab is left with territorial jurisdiction. So the where the Nawabs, Bengal Nawab Sirajuddaula are were defeated in the and became the puppets of the Robert Clive Britishers East India Company. While the Nawab is with just for territorial, Nawabs are just like puppets, became puppets of the Britishers, and the company got the Diwani jurisdiction. Total economically they looted India. So this is the about the Robert Clive, the governor of Bengal. So due to his elegance leadership and to win the battle of Plassey against Siraj Daula, and so he became the founder of British Indian Empire. So after this, Governor Generals of Bengal has been started. The Governors of Bengal, now Governor Generals of Bengal. And the last Governor General of Bengal, last Governor General, not here, the last Governor of Bengal. So here the last Governor of Bengal was Warren Hastings from 1772 to 1774. And Warren Hastings became the last governor of Bengal and the first governor general of Bengal in 1774. So remember these two points. These are attached each other. The last governor of Bengal was also Warren Hastings, and the first governor general of Bengal was also the Warren Hastings. In 1774, the governor general he became, and governor of Bengal from 72 to 74. So let's see the reforms of Warren Hastings. The only governor general against him impeachment proceeding were initiated in England, because the governor generals were ruling India, but the acts, the reforms were came from the England, like the Charter Act. Every 20 years a new Charter Act has been coming. They who should follow? The governor generals, the viceroy should follow the acts and administer the India. So he was the only governor general which he not resigned, he not returned, he was not dismissed, but he was impeached. Like that today we Indian president has the should be impeached by the 2/3 majority of the seats. So like this also, by the 2/3 majority of seats, Governor General of Bengal Warren Hastings was impeached. So in the history of the England, the only Governor General who was impeached was Warren Hastings. Okay friends, his period was called as trial and error. His period was called as. So remember all these points. These are the question and answers which will be come in your future exams. So let's see the administration of Warren Hastings. Regulating act of 1773, for the first time in the East India Company history, regulating act was came from the England to rule the India. And act to regulate, what was the act? East India Company in India by British Crown created office of Governor General of Bengal. In that act, regulating act of 1773, it has written that the Governor General of Bengal office should be newly created, and the dual system which was in Bengal, double governance, should be abolished. It was written in the regulating act of 1773. And Warren Hastings appointed collectors to collect revenue and look into judicial affairs. Who appointed collectors? Warren Hastings appointed collectors and collect revenue and look into judicial affairs. And Pitt's India Act of 1784. In 1784, Pitt's India Act came. to India from England to rectify the defects of 1773 Act. What was the 1773 Act? Regulating Act. So Pitt's India Act in 1784 came to rectify the defects of 1773 Act. So next is next one. Established a board of control in Britain to supervise company affairs in India. So in England, in Britain, board of control in Britain, board was established to supervise the company affairs in India. How the governor generals, how the generals are working in India, how the administration and how the policies are being implemented. So this board is supervising in India. So the subordination of presidency of Bombay and Madras under governor general, and the subordination presidencies were Bombay, no, present Mumbai, and Madras, the present Chennai. It was under the subordination of governor general. And the judiciary, and Warren Hastings established each and every district a civil and a criminal court and a supreme court. Now the supreme court is present in Delhi, but the supreme court of Britishers were the Calcutta. Now the high court of Calcutta is the that time the supreme court of Calcutta. In 1774 it was built. So friends, education established Calcutta, Madras, the first educational institute by the company in 1781 for the promotion of Islamic studies and Asiatic Society of Bengal with William Jones to understand the Indian culture. So education was also implemented in Warren Hastings period in Calcutta and Madras. In 1781 it established an Islamic study madrasa and Asiatic Society in Bengal with William Jones in 1784 to understand the Indian culture. And the first English translation of Bhagavad Gita was done by Charles Hawkins in Warren Hastings period. So press, publication of first Indian newspaper. You know what was the first Indian newspaper? Bengal Gazette was the first Indian newspaper and was introduced in Warren Hastings period. And expansion, the first Anglo-Maratha War 1775-82 ended in favor of British by the Treaty of Salbai. So British Empire has expanded by Anglo-Maratha War. Anglo-Maratha War, when was Anglo-Maratha War done? 1775-82, and Britishers won the battle, and in favor of British, the Treaty of Salbai came into existence. So these all treaties important, remember friends. So next, see that Governor General Lord Cornwallis. He ruled as a Governor General of Bengal from 1786 to 1793. The most successful lord in administrative reforms. The Cornwallis is also known as the most successful lord in administrative reforms and popularly known as the father of police reforms. In his rule, police reforms were developed. Administration. Separation of revenue and justice administration under Cornwallis Code 1793 deprived the collectors of the judicial function. He separated the revenue and justice administration under 1793 code and deprived the collectors of the judicial functions, and the collectors should take the judicial functions. And permanent settlement of zamindari system in 1793 to declare zamindar as the owner of the land, and the person who has land, he became the zamindar. So this permanent settlement system was introduced by the Lord Cornwallis. And the act of 1786 empowered Governor General to override council decision. And the 1786 Act came from England. Empowered, what has the Governor General power has been doubled by what? To override, he can override the council's decision. He should not agree or disagree with the council's decision. And judiciary, set up for appellate courts at Calcutta, Dhaka, Murshidabad, Patna, codified the personal laws. Judiciary was also established in Lord Cornwallis, and the four courts was established at Calcutta, now present Calcutta, and the Dhaka, the Bangladesh capital city Dhaka, and the Murshidabad, and the Patna. These four courts were established. And police and civil service. Introduction to civil service in India in 1793 to check corruption, police reforms to maintain law and order, and appointed Daroga, means constable at Thanas, and district head, superintendent of police, SP. It were all established by Lord Cornwallis. Okay friends. And expansion, how the territorial was expanded during Lord Canning, the third Anglo-Mysore war, which has happened in 1792, and in favor of British, the British has won the war, and the Treaty of Srirangapatnam, the famous treaty, you must remember it, 1792, between the Anglo-Mysore war during the period of Warren Cornwallis. So friends, Next, Governor General is famous John Sir. Sir John Sir. He from 1793 to 1798 he ruled Bengal as a Governor General of Bengal from 1793 to 1798. Indirectly they were all ruling India, but the headquarters were Calcutta. So famous for his policy of non-intervention. His famous policy was non-intervention. Introduced the first Charter Act of 1793. And the first Charter Act, you do know the first charter, second, third, fourth, fifth. Every 20 years a new Charter Act came from the England, and the new policies and new administrative reforms were present in it. Who should they follow it? The Governor General should follow and implement in the place where they have been ruled. So the first Charter of 1793 came in. Charter Act came in Sir John Sir period. So not so much important was Governor General, as much as we have talked about Cornwallis and Warren Hastings. They were the most important. So remember it just. So next is the Lord Arthur Wellesley. He is also the famous Governor General of Bengal. He ruled Governor General of Bengal from 1798 to 1805, and known as the father of civil services in India. Who is the father of civil services in India? Lord Arthur Wellesley. Administration was Wellesley's. Adopted the policy of subsidiary alliance. Who introduced the policy of subsidiary alliance? Means Lord Wellesley adopted the policy of subsidiary alliance, and to exercise the control over Indian rulers. And he, because the several parts of India was ruling by the several Indian monarchs, rulers, the Nizams, the Tipu Sultan, many of them were ruling the India in Tanjore, Awadh, Jodhpur, Jaipur, Udaipur, Gwalior, Indore, Bhonsle, all over came under the policy of subsidiary alliance under the British. And the formation of Madras Presidency was formed in 1801 under Lord Wellesley. And civil services, he is the father of civil services. Founded Fort William College at Calcutta to train the civil servants for better coordination in governance. To train the civil, today we know the civil servants are trained in LBSNN, Lal Bahadur Station, Stadium, National Academy of Administration, where the IAS has been trained. So like that time, in that British period, civil services, the trainees were trained under the Fort William College, which was present in Calcutta and which was established in Lord Wellesley period. And the press, at that time, today we are seeing the journalism press. So at that time, the press was also introduced, and the Censorship of Press Act means to censorship, to because the press reporters to not to rule the Britishers, they impose wartime press restrictions. Means the press run all time, and daily reports and newspapers were distributed. But at the war time, when the war between two peoples or war between Britishers are happening, at that time the press has to be restricted. Means no news will be go outside, and no newspaper will be distributed. And expansion. So expansion of British Empire in Lord Wellesley period. Second Anglo-Maratha War happened in Lord Wellesley period from 1803 to 1805 and ended in favor of British, and British won the battle. So after C. Wellesley, Sir George Barlow became the Governor General of Bengal from 1805 to 1807. Vellore Mutiny by Indian soldiers against exploitation by English officials. The Vellore Mutiny in 1806 happened in the Governor General period of George Barlow. So after see the Lord Minto won the Governor General of Bengal from 1807 to 1813. Charter Act of 1813 ended monopoly of EIC, East India Company, to trade with India except trade in tea and trade with China. So we have seen the 1793 the Charter Act, first Charter Act came, and after 20 years 1830 the new Charter Act came with new administrative reforms and new policies to be implemented in the rule. So you know what was the Charter Act of 1830? That monopoly in East India Company was ended, and to trade with India, and everyone can trade with India, and India will also trade with everyone, but except trade in tea and trade with China. So Britishers will not, the people cannot trade with China in tea plantation. Only Britishers will trade with టీ ఇన్ చైనా ఇన్ లార్డ్ మింటో రిఫార్మ్స్ అండ్ ట్రీటీ ఆఫ్ అమృత్సర్ వెన్ వాట్ ట్రీటీ ఆఫ్ అమృత్సర్ హ్యాపెన్ 1809 విత్ హోమ్ కింగ్ రంజీత్ సింగ్ అండ్ సెటిల్డ్ ఆంగ్లో సిక్ రిలేషన్ ఫర్ జనరేషన్స్ సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద రిఫార్మ్స్ ఇన్ లార్డ్ మింటో వన్ గవర్నర్ జనరల్ ఆఫ్ బెంగాల్ అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద గవర్నర్ జనరల్ వాస్ లార్డ్ హేస్టింగ్ 1813 టు 1823 10 ఇయర్స్ He was the first British officer to appoint India to the highest post of responsibility like Indian Munsif etc. to strengthen British Empire. Lord Hastings was the first British officer to be appointed in the India's highest post that is Munsif, Indian Munsif to strengthen the British Empire in India. Lord Hastings' administration was replaced the policy of non-intervention. He replaced the policy of non-intervention started by Sir John Shore. Sir John Shore started it. An imperialistic policy of war and annexed all Indian territories except Punjab and Sindh by 1818. At 1818 in his rule, he annexed in British Empire all Indian territories except Punjab and Sindh and abolished the Peshawarship. Peshawarship was abolished in Bombay Presidency in 1880 by Lord Hastings and Lord Hastings introduced the Rotwari system in Madras and Malwari system in Bombay. And Northwestern provinces. So who introduced? Lord Hastings introduced the Rotwari system and Malwari system. So press. What about press? Abolished the censorship of press. The first vernacular newspaper Samachar Patrika was published. So as we know that at wartime the press was restricted. So he abolished the censorship of press. Lord Hastings and the first vernacular newspaper Samachar Patrika published in Lord Hastings period. And see expansion, how the British territory was expanded during his reign. Anglo-Nepal was ended by, Anglo-Nepal war was ended by Treaty of Saugali establishing boundary line of Nepal. Nepal boundary line was established and Treaty of Saugali was established during Lord Hastings, Governor General of Bengal period. After this, next Governor General was Lord Amherst. Lord Amherst. 1823 to 1828 he ruled as Governor General of Bengal and he was the witness of the mutiny of Barakpur the Barakpur mutiny 1824 it was happened he was the, at that time the Governor General of Bengal and the first Anglo-Burmese war ended with a treaty of Yendabu treaty between first Anglo-Burmese war in 1826 under the Governor Generalship of Lord Amherst and the last Governor General of Bengal was the Lord William Bentinck, 1828 to 1833, 5 years. And he was the last Governor General of Bengal after enhancement of Charter Act of 1833. As I told that Regulating Act came as a Charter Act in 1793. Every 20 years a new act will come into existence from the England, Britain. In 1793 the first act and 1813 the second act. And after 1813, 20 years, 1833. New Charter Act came into enhancement and in that Charter Act it was written that the Governor General of Bengal system should be abolished and a new system should be enhanced as the first Governor General of India. So the last Governor General of India who was the Lord William Bentinck, he reappointed as the first Governor General of India. So in the next video I will teach you about the Governor Generals of India. And this first Governor General of India, what was the reforms taken up by the William Bentinck and the continuation part of the Governor Generals of India. And in further video, I will explain the Viceroys. So if you like this video, please comment it, like it, share it. So stay home, stay safe. I will meet you in the next video. Thank you.